Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts. I was looking for a thread holder that would hold cones so I could use them on my vintage sewing machines. And I found the Superior thread holder. And this is what it is. It comes with the thread holder. It comes with a small spool cap, a large spool cap, a cone adapter, and a spool pin that's actually a bobbin adapter, they call it. So let me just show you how this works. It's very versatile and you can use lots of different types of spools and cones of thread on it. It'll come looking like this, and this looks a bit wobbly now because I haven't got it screwed in all the way. It actually unscrews. So this is your spool pin, and it can be used either in a vertical or a horizontal position. So if you are using smaller spools or like the regular spools of thread, you're going to want to screw it in to the threaded hole in the side here. So not the bottom one, but this one here. Then what you can do is if you're using a regular spool of thread, you're going to put it on. You're going to want to put on the large spool cap for this one. And you want to feed it up here, and then we're going to move the arm up and feed it through the arm. But it's rather awkward to try and pull this up through here at this point in time. And actually, I've got my thread caught a little bit here, so let me just pull that out. I need to find that loose end of thread. There it goes. So what I want to do is take the thread holder, lay it on its side, and then feed the thread through the little hole there. That's much easier. Now the arm moves up, and then I can feed the thread through it. And then it's gonna pull out in this manner. Now if you're having a little bit of problem pulling, like I'm having a little bit of problem, just back off that spool cap a bit, and that'll flow it easily through the thread arm. Okay, that's one type of spool of thread. I'm going to take off my large spool cap, and it sticks on there really well, so you don't have to worry about that jiggling loose as you're stitching. Let's say you have this kind of a spool. You're going to put it on. I'm probably going to use the small spool cap for that one. That should work just fine. Again, I want to make sure it's close but not inhibiting the flow of the thread. There we go. And that would just feed it up and through the arm again, and it would be ready to go. But sometimes you have different types of spools, more like cones, and that's not going to work sideways. We want that to feed off from a vertical position. So I just unscrew it, the spool pin, and put it back where it was originally, down the bottom. And now I want to put on my Orfill thread. So it's going to go like that. I can put an adapter on if I want, but I don't think I'm even going to need to. Typically I wouldn't. But if you wanted to, if your thread was, your spool, I should say, was jumping around a lot, you could put that on. And then of course I would just feed it up and through the arm again, like I did before. What if I have a really large cone? So here's my cone of King Tut. This is actually called Denial. I love this color. It's not going to fit on there. It's going to move around quite a bit on the spool pin if I don't have something in to hold it steady. So there is a cone adapter here. You can just push it on. It'll take a little bit of force to get it on. And then you can put that on there and it holds it quite steady. It's going to unravel and I'm going to feed it up through the hole, through the thread arm, and it's ready to go. Now, it also has the ability of using threads off of a bobbin. And that's what this little bobbin adapter is for. So it's going to go on the back. Now, it's not going to go into the same hole where we screwed the spool pin before, because that's threaded and this is not. This is just a push-in one. So there's a little one on the little hole in the bottom. Just going to push it in there, put the felt on, and you can put your bobbin in and then just feed it up through the arm and it's ready to go. So very versatile. Will work with just about any cone or spool of thread. And if you're not sure how to use it, it of course comes with instructions on the back of the package. And it stays very stable when you're sewing with it. It actually, even though it's plastic, is quite stable. And I found it works very well with any of my cones or spools I need to use with my vintage sewing machines. So give it a try, the Superior Thread Holder. If you're not sure where to find the Superior Thread Holder, look in the description below and I have a link to where you can purchase it.